And we are going to move in that direction by starting with tonight's big story, like really big, like globally big story, like how the country and world can't seem to believe that our state Republican Party is defending conspiracy theories about the Capitol attack, something that has Republican lawmakers in Oregon taking extraordinary steps to distance themselves from after we did reach out to each and every single one of them for comment. See, let me rewind a little bit. Last week, the state Republican Party Executive Committee, they passed a resolution condemning the 10 Republican lawmakers in Congress who voted to impeach President Trump. But that really wasn't the part of this that got everyone to say, ha, what's that? That was this part where they wrote this. There is growing evidence that the violence of the Capitol was a false flag operation designed to discredit President Trump, his supporters, and all conservative Republicans. It went on to say this false flag effort will support Joe Biden's plans to introduce new domestic terrorism legislation. This is not at all based with any fact whatsoever. And House Republicans said as much after we asked them for their opinion. They sent us a statement that says, in part, we have it on the screen, there is no credible evidence to support false flag claims, signed by all of the Republicans in the House, names that you know, people you have seen before on TV and in newspapers. And that's what leads me to this next tweet I got from Renee, because Renee wanted to know more. She tweeted us and asked, hey, Dan, specifically, who are the members of the Oregon Republican Party Executive Committee who made that false and embarrassing statement about January 6th? So, here's kind of the quick answer. It's probably not going to be as specific as you'd like, because that would take a while. But these are mostly people you probably haven't heard of, you know, behind the scenes kind of folks, not elected lawmakers. It's a 22-person committee that is picked by other members of the GOP at an annual convention. And the purpose of this group is to more or less help dictate the direction of the party. They're also supposed to hold each other accountable. So if a Republican does something they don't think is in the best interest of the party, they'll try and do something about that. Now, the resolution that you're questioning, Renee, is something that that whole 22-person group should have voted on. But we're never going to know the details of that unless they choose to make that public. The chairman is a guy named Bill Currier, and he hasn't responded to any of my calls or texts, but I haven't seen a comment regarding the backlash either. But I did find this clip of him on Straight Talk in 2019 defending the Republican walkout over cap and trade.
Those brave 11 senators walked out of that session, putting everything on the line in order to represent their constituents and those concerns, and they were very successful in doing so. I can't think of a better way to represent your constituents than to put everything on the line.
Well, it's all on the line, Bill, so let's talk about it, all right? Again, I'm trying to get in touch with Currier to talk about his stance on this false flag statement and some of the other lies that were printed in that resolution. Now, I know when I use that word lies, a lot of you at home cringe because you don't think it sounds, it doesn't sound very journalistic, impartially journalistic of me. Marnie emailed me what's on your screen now. She emailed me this last night, and it says, I'm so disappointed every time I listen to Dan spin the stories he covers into his poorly informed, non-fact-checked, democratic, one-sided, and skewed line of thinking. It's a shame his reportive style includes pushing his agenda and putting down those who disagree with him. And I know she's not the only person that feels that way when we talk the way we do about topics like this one, especially when they're dealing with Democrats and Republicans and the touchy issues that we have to cover sometimes. But I want to explain something to you from a journalist's perspective. You know that saying, there are two sides to every story? That's not true. Sometimes there are three sides or five sides or 10 sides. And sometimes, like in this case, there's one side. Let me explain it to you like this. Let's say the two of us are standing on the front porch and you say you believe that it's raining. And I look up and I notice there's not a cloud in the sky and it's a sunny day. Well, your belief is wrong. No matter how strongly you believe it, it's not raining. See, we know the people who were at the Capitol that day. The FBI opened 400 individual investigations. They have arrested 135 people. They searched their social media, their bank records, their voter registration, court files, cell phones, so on and so forth. It's the FBI. They have 140,000 videos and photos that they're going through and identifying people. And the Bureau already stated publicly that there was no evidence of Antifa involvement in the Capitol mob. Conversely, there is a nearly endless pile of evidence that points to Republicans and far-right militants and white supremacists being in that crowd, and people who think that the government is secretly controlled by a cabal of Satan-worshipping pedophile cannibals, you know, Q people. See, it really comes down to misinformation. We talk about it on the show and I'll keep talking about it until I'm blue in the face. I want to give you a good example of how something like this can get out of control. See, this guy here got arrested at the Capitol. His name is John Sullivan. He said that he was there to, quote, document the event. He's on video yelling, "Burn the expletive down," as people are storming inside. And he told the media he was a BLM supporter. Court records, also uncovered by the media, show that he was once arrested at an anti-police riot in Utah over the summer. So when this story and this guy's face hits the internet, it starts to fuel misinformation about the entire situation. People started focusing only on that one person and speculating what that might mean. We've all played telephone, right? You remember that in grade school? Suddenly, people start to forget or omit the fact that they have information on thousands of other people, and a narrative is born, a lie. Lies like this that get emboldened when people in leadership support them by nonchalantly dropping, without citing any fact, that there's growing evidence of a false flag operation. Now, we're still asking for statements from our Republicans in the Senate. We'll let you know how this story unfolds.